Senator Manny Pacquiao accused the DOH as one of the most corrupt agencies. And Secretary Duque just read the utilization rate of Bayanihan 1 and 2. Mm-hmm. Are you satisfied with the performance of the Health Department?
Not satisfied, Karen. And in fact, that's part of my pending resolution requesting the Commission on Audit to conduct a special audit of our COVID-19 expenses. Dun pa lang sa Bayanihan 1, no? And then I've been calling for the executive, Malacanang, to pick up yung naputol nila. Kalahating taon ng naputol na weekly reports dapat sa ating mamamayan sa Kongreso of, again, their COVID-19 expenses. And of course, the DOH is front and center of what should be that spending for our health response. So I'm not at all satisfied with the performance so far of the DOH, not in terms of performance on the ground and not in terms of reporting to the people paano ginagastos ang bawat piso natin para sa kalusugan.
So you feel there's a lack of transparency?
There is a lack of transparency or cuts in the transparent communication to the public, because why was the last Malacanang weekly report way back in January, more than half a year ago? Bakit hindi pa rin nagkakaroon nga ng COA special audit? Of course, they are not an executive body, they are a constitutional body, but you know, why hasn't there been action towards a special audit of the spending of DOH and all the other agencies moving under the or within the IATF.
Okay, Bloomberg came out with a study and ranks the Philippines 52nd out of 53 economies. So second to the last in terms of a resiliency ranking with the COVID programs. And you heard Secretary Duque, he said it's unfair, it's skewed towards countries who have a lot of supply of vaccine. And he went as far as saying, I'm pissed with this report. So what do you make of that Bloomberg report?
I think, Karen, ang dapat talagang ma-piss off ay hindi yung health secretary, pero yung ating mga mamamayan, not with the Bloomberg report, because it's just the latest reflection of the truth on the ground. Ang talagang nakakabuisit, nakakadismaya sa mamamayan is the very poor health response, and twinning that, the poor economic response. Unfair ba yung Bloomberg report? Mas unfair na this health and economic response has been so poor in protecting our people from the worst effects of COVID-19 and of the recession. Skewed daw towards vaccination administration. But my gosh, yung vaccination is already the fifth in our set of life-saving responses to the COVID pandemic. Last year pa dapat, nagpo-procure na tayo or nagsisignify ng intention to procure in addition to what we would be receiving through COVAX. Yung unang apat na steps nga, Karen, test, trace, isolate, or quarantine and treat. Hanggang ngayon, we haven't come up to speed with that, and vaccination is just already the fifth step. Sisisihin pa ba natin yung Bloomberg? Hey, they're just doing their duty as a very, you know, dispassionate, hard-nosed economic publication and monitor. Rather than getting mad at Bloomberg, we should step up. Kasi hindi naman Bloomberg ang ikanga nag-drop ng ball. I'm sorry. It was the Health Department under the leadership of the good secretary that has been dropping the ball so far.
Mm-mm. Okay.